Is it hot today again? I guess it is. And reading the articles today, apparently there were some records. It says here, BC heatwave shatters temperature records across the province. Lytton, Abbotsford, and Lillooet were some of the hottest places in BC on Saturday. Apparently tomorrow, Monday, is supposed to be the hottest out of this whole, I guess, week. It says here, from Abbotsford to Yoho National Park, a heat wave shattered temperature records in British Columbia on Saturday, and meteorologists expect the weather to get even hotter over the next couple of days. The village of Lytton was the hottest place in the country Saturday with a record-breaking 43.2 degrees Celsius, according to Environment Canada. The previous record there was set in 2006 at 39.9 degrees Celsius. There's even cooling stations in some places where literally it's just like an indoor place that's air conditioned. It actually makes me wonder how busy the malls and stuff are, because those are air conditioned, and I know a lot of people, they'll probably just hang around because they don't have air conditioning, let's just say, in their buildings or houses. Although I always was interested in making one of those cheap ones to see if you can actually do it. For example, just take like a box or something like that, put a bunch of frozen ice in there, have a fan blow out through these vents, and there you go. You got like an air conditioner, apparently. That's how some people do it, as opposed to spending like $200 to $300 for something temporary. And I guess there were some crazy military drones in the news. Although just from reading this, I don't know if this is just flexing to intimidate, I guess, the other side. This one says, Iran claims it has drones capable of flying 7,000 kilometers. Republican Guard General Hussein Salami says UAVs can fly, return home, and land wherever they are planned to. If true, distance would put Israel and Europe within range. Iran has drones with a range of 7,000 kilometers that can reach well beyond Israel, a top commander of the country's Revolutionary Guard claimed Sunday. Iran has made dubious and exaggerated claims regarding its military capabilities in the past, and there was no outside confirmation of the latest assertion, saying, quote, "We have unmanned aerial vehicles with a long range of 7,000 kilometers." The United States and Israel reportedly held talks earlier this month on cooperation against unmanned Iranian drones, with which the Islamic Republic is believed to be arming Shiite militias and terrorist organizations in the region. And funny enough, this actually got me to think of things like over-the-top regulations, how there's no classification or difference in a lot of cases when it comes to, let's just say, a quote, toy drone and a military one. Because it says, one idea reportedly raised in the meeting was establishing a no-fly zone in the Middle East for Iranian UAVs. So like there, would they necessarily mean something humongous, for example, like these military ones? Or does technically a toy qualify as like a UAV as well? Like some kid or whatever flying within their house for fun? Because that's how it is in many places. Like here, if they have like a restriction or whatever, it doesn't matter what it is. It could be like a 1 gram drone. It's technically illegal to fly that. In my opinion, that's just a really lazy way, in my opinion, to handle things like regulations and all. Just ban them all, classify them all pretty much as the same thing. Imagine trying to get away with that with more mainstream stuff. It will never follow through. Example, you fear spies carrying cameras and stuff like that. So because of that, you have this rule where any camera within this vicinity, any item or whatever, is going to be banned, like in a general public area as well. That includes things like your smartphone and stuff like that. That would be ridiculous.
Thank you.
All right. See you guys later.